Yo ho ho, we got a big boy in the shop.
Yeah man, I'm gonna tell you what man, we got this massive Ferguson 280 by Hella. Man, she's a big old farm piece of machinery.
That's right, this is a big kit. Now I've built a tractor before, but it was that little bitty Porsche tractor, that little diesel. This monster, 45 pieces total, came in from Model Roundup. Let's take a look at everything that's in the box. Now this one is in 1/24 scale, so it's gonna be just a hair bigger, obviously, than your average kit in 1/25th. And being a giant four-wheel drive tractor, it's gonna make it even bigger. We've got some beautiful molding on the wheels there. We got one side, we'll flip them around. You can see the back side's not very detailed. We've got a bunch of small parts here, fenders on the front wheels. We've got transmission and PTO parts. We've got front steering bodies. We've got rear pins. We've got part of the power takeoff and rear attachment assembly there. Not a massive amount of parts in the kit, but good enough to have nice detail. We've got the frame halves with the engine. We'll have to pick out some of that detail in hand. I think I want to weather this one up. That's my plan right now. We've got the axles there, the drive axles, their halves. So I think I want to weather this bad boy up, so I'm going to have to do some hand painting and do some greasing and some beating up with it. And we've done that before, so you'll get to see that. We've got the nice dashboard here. And now we've got things that will really make you recognize as a tractor. We've got that huge one-piece hood. All right, we've got the actual back of the chassis. This is where the operator's area is. This is also the rear fenders on there. And we've got the operator's seat in two halves. You can see it right there. What else we got in the kit? Well, we've got some tires. We've got some decals, decals, my British friends love to say, and I like to imitate it. We've got beautiful dash detail. We've got the Massey Ferguson logos. We've got our lights, and we've got a plate there, so that'll be easy to work on. A little less masking. The tires are no name, smooth wall, but they do look very nice, and they have the chevron pattern. They are a hollow, squidgy rubber. They will be very easy to sand and detail. I mean, look at that in my hand. That's a lot bigger than your average car because it's a big tractor. So I'm gonna go soak everything in some Simple Green to clean it up. I'm gonna get some assemblies done, and before we head to paint, we'll take a quick look. Assembly up to this point goes super easy. Everything fits together nice. There's no huge seams to worry about. Between glue and paint, you'll cover up all those seams. If you don't glue it, it does press fit together. It's a friction fit, like a Snap-Tite. You can always go ahead and fill those in with putty or whatever you wish. But this is the main chassis and the engine. It's all one large piece. Then we add our side steps, our cab brace, our PTO and attachment point back here, and our front axle and steering mechanism. That's all one large piece, and luckily that all gets painted the same gray color. We've got our fenders ready to go. Those will be primed in black, then gloss coated. And before that is, I have to mask off these arms, which stay the same gray. The hood will get painted in a primer. Then it will be masked off right back here and sprayed with my main body color. The main frame here will get primed in all black. Then I will mask off so that just my fenders and outer area all get colored in the main Massey Ferguson red, or as close as I can get. The actuators on the hydraulic arms for the PTO and the attachment point, I just slid down a toothpick so I can paint those a metallic, and then those will be ready to go. These are the rear hubs. They'll just get stuck into some poster putty so I can paint them the gray color. The wheels will get painted up with a flat black and then the main gray color like they have it. So those will just stay on their tree. I've assembled the exhaust. That's the only part that needed it, was the exhaust, the steering wheel, the air intake, and the exhaust will all be painted black and weathered up later. Our dashboard is one piece that gets painted black. Our weights in the front will get painted a metallic color because they just kind of hang off the front. Our seat will get painted all black. We'll go all black on this one, and then I will hand paint the cushion a dark red later. So the cab is all masked off. There's a good amount of masking involved in this. It's a large clear piece that we need to have just some borders revealed. And then, of course, I mask off the back so when I spray, I don't hose down the back and get clouded windows. So that's ready to go. The main cab itself, I left on its handy little tree so I can hold it and spray it. But we've got the glass masked off all the way around. And then I went and masked the interior so I don't get any overspray. Not worried about the roof, that's solid anyways. Or in the areas back here, those will all get paint anyways. So anything that doesn't have any masking on it will get painted a light gray. In fact, it'll just pretty much stay primer, so it's not the exact same gray as the rest of the body. Tractors aren't really painted up a lot of super fancy colors. So what I'm going to do now is get into priming, and you can come along with me. Out of that fun paint processing where we masked and remasked and got everything to look good, check out the masking on the cab. It came out wonderfully. We can get it all looking nice now, like it was actually actual frame and a bunch of glazing in it. The cab itself came out real nice. Just take some time masking. It's not hard at all. And trace it out with a new X-Acto knife blade. You can get it to look just as good. We got the wheels and tires together. They look phenom. They're just huge for a model kit that we normally build with a car or like a military kit. They look absolutely wonderful. We've got the main chassis, drivetrain, suspension, which is all one part in these vehicles. All I have to do is some minor detailing. I'm not going to do the radiator. You can't see it whatsoever with the hood on, and I'm not going to be taking it off and playing with it. But the parts you can see, like the oil filters, the exhaust manifolds, I'm going to be painting those up, doing a little weathering, doing a little washing and oil marking and chipping. We're going to be working on it just a little bit, doing stuff like that. We've got the exhaust all done. That just has to be rusted and a little beat up. We've got the fenders done. The reason the paint is not very glossy on the exterior body parts is because I hit it all with a coat of my favorite Treehouse Studios matte coating. I get this at Hobby Lobby. What that's going to do is give me a good surface for my weathering, and it also dulls down that finish so that it looks like it's been sitting out in the sun. But we got those fenders two-toned, black and gray like the manual. We got the weights on the front in bare metal. I like that look. We've got the hood done, and with that thin Krylon paint with the masking off, you can see with the flat coat shot in certain areas and left off, we get a lot of tonal variation. We get a lot of different coloring. Looks like it's been sitting out in the field. Same with the red on the actual main body, the chassis and the fuel tank. We've got some fading and glossing underneath. We don't have to be too precise with those cut lines because the cab covers those, but we've got the interior black. So all I'm going to be doing now is doing some little bit of weathering. We've seen this in other videos. I've got to hand paint the seat and get that in. I've got to do a little bit of hand painting on the engine, get the hood on it and everything. So, and I'll be doing some other weathering detail. You've seen that all in other reviews. For more tips and tricks on this, go check out my Caterpillar D8H review from AMT. That'll show you how I'm going to be doing everything moving forward. I'm going to keep working, and as I get more stuff done, we'll come back for another look. All right, I've been working for a couple hours, wearing in this tractor, making it look like it's been around for a few years. As you can see, I've got that nice plush seat in the driver's area. We've got some paint chip effects going on. We've got faded red paint. We've got just a little bit of dirt underneath. What I have to do is get out my my tiling grout and start dusting it up after I assemble it. You can see I've got some oil drips that look wet running out of the fuel tank. We've got the weights on the front just a little bit rusty. We've got the hood, which I think looks great with that decal on there, dirtied up a little bit. It's a phenom looking hood. We got it faded. We've got the front end a little dirty. Now I just got to put the decals on there for the lights. We've got our wheels rusted, a little chipped with some dry brushing, and then I'll have to dust up the tires themselves with tile grout. I did it on the front and the rear. The front tires, I did get the rust effect a little stronger and the paint chip a little stronger since they're turning and going sideways and being ground into more stuff. The main chassis and engine, we did some small detail painting, rusted out that exhaust manifold. They rust almost immediately. Painted in some filters, painted in some lines, painted the radiator hoses, didn't do the radiator because we'll never be able to see it, painted the filters, painted the starter, and dripped oil and whatnot off there, ground out some bolt heads, added some chip effects and dirt effects. We're not going to make this thing absolutely filthy, we're just going to make it a little dirty, a little used. And then on the cab itself, I haven't dusted it yet, but all I wanted to do, because that sits up pretty high, is just do a little where the paint has been rubbed off from sitting outside, and you can see on the roof it's a little uneven and a little weather beat up from the top there. The windows we'll dust up once the cab is on, just a little bit, and that'll be ready to go. The upper cab doesn't get too filthy. So all I have to do now is start pushing stuff together. Once it's all pushed together, that's the nice part about being a Snaptite. Once it's all pushed together, then I can go ahead, add my dust effects, add my headlights, taillights, everything on there, and we'll be all done. We'll see you for a final in just a second. The vehicle of the working man, the farmer, the Massey Ferguson 2680 by Heller is all done. Once again, we thank Model Roundup for sending us this sample kit for review. You can pick this up. It is actually a Snaptite kit. And once again, look what you can do with a Snaptite kit if you just put a little time into it, throw a little paint at it, you can make it look pretty darn nice. Now, I enjoyed every bit of this build. There were no fit issues, there were no other problems. The masking of the canopy is the only tedious part. You do have to mask off the hood in certain sections and the rear of the driver's compartment, but that's not a big deal. You saw that I busted through that quite easily. The paints I used were listed. This was 2 days. The dust you see is from tile grout, puffed on with a paintbrush, and then wiped off of areas that I wanted to wipe it off. I didn't go extreme. I went with a little bit of fuel staining off the fuel cap there. I went with a little bit of oil staining off the engine, some fluid stains and drips and glabs off the muffler as it heats up. We rusted up the muffler. We chipped up the air cleaner. We did some scratch effects. You can see all of these in my Caterpillar D8H review, where I go more in depth on how I weather and beat things up a little bit. But as I always say, I like things used up, or used but not used up. I don't like things that are a complete derelict out in the field. This tractor looks like he's working planting or harvest season. If they're not dirty, they're not making any money. So the front wheels will still turn on this kit as long as you don't put too much glue, because I used glue because I wanted it to hold. But if you do use a little bit of glue, just make sure you leave those front spindles loose and your front tires will turn as well. The front fork will also tilt left and right and articulate. The rear end is a solid axle, does not move whatsoever. So I think it's pretty cool. I wish they made some attachments for this PTO and the attachment rack off the back. That'd be kind of cool to have a mower on there or anything else. These and other type of Heller kits are available at modelroundup.com. We thank you for your time. We thank you for your viewership. Like, comment below, and we will see you at the next review.